friends, this video on Nuclei Part 3 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Please make sure that you have watched Part 1 and Part 2 before going ahead with Part 3. So now we are done with the basic knowledge on nucleus. So now we know what is a nucleus, what is the approximate size of a nucleus, what is nucleus composed of, what is the net charge on a nucleus. So we know the basic things about nucleus. Nucleus is positively charged, it consists of protons and neutrons. Atomic number and mass number of nucleus is a critical thing to determine properties of a nucleus. The size of a nucleus is extremely small, however it was found later that nuclear radius r is related to the mass number of the nucleus. So now we will talk about Einstein's mass energy equivalence. So you might be thinking that suddenly I was talking about nucleus and suddenly I came to something called mass energy equivalence. Am I going out of the track? No, I'm actually not. Because in the next part of this lesson, we will talk about nuclear energy. We will talk about nuclear binding energy. So we will talk about things like how is it that the neutrons and protons are held together and they form a nucleus. Why is it not that the neutrons and protons get separated away from each other? Why don't they get separated? What holds them together? So we'll talk about all those things. So whenever we talk about nuclear energy or nuclear binding energy, I mean whenever we talk about the energy aspects of a nucleus, we will need this mass energy equivalence relation. So let us first see what is this mass energy equivalence. Einstein told that mass is also a form of energy. Before, during the Newtonian era, we all know that mass is something different and energy is something different. So mass was never compared to energy, right? But Einstein was the one who told that mass is also a form of energy. So mass energy, he called this energy as mass energy. So that means the energy associated with a mass. So he told that mass energy can also be converted into other forms of energy. I mean, when you think of electrical energy or heat energy or light energy, we know that they can be converted into different forms. For example, when you switch on the fan, you're switching on the fan, so the mechanical energy is getting converted into the electrical energy. Right? Similarly, when you switch on a light bulb, so the electrical energy is getting converted into light energy. So similarly, Einstein told that even mass energy was also convertible. So mass energy can also get converted into other forms of energy. So according to Einstein, the mass energy equivalence relation is, how do we define this mass energy? So how do we know how much energy is associated with a mass m? So according to Einstein, the mass energy is given as E is equal to mc squared. That means if you have a mass m, the mass energy associated with it is mc squared. So mc squared denotes its mass energy. So that means any object which has got a mass m, it has got energy associated with that mass. That energy is not because of its kinetic, because of its motion or because of its position or something. It is because of the fact that this object has mass. So anything that has mass has a mass energy associated with it. And that mass energy is given as E is equal to mc squared. And this equation became very popular and came to be known as Einstein's mass energy equivalence. Now, why are we studying this here? Because this relation helps in understanding nuclear masses and interaction of nuclei with each other. Because now, as I mentioned, now in the next half of the chapter, we will talk about the mass of a nucleus. So whenever we talk about the nuclear mass, we basically talk about the nuclear mass energy. Because that's what I mentioned previously also, right? So this atomic mass is not similar to the heavier masses which we see around us. Since this mass is extremely small, so there are certain other units which have been employed here. For example, the atomic mass unit. Similarly, this mass energy equivalence was also put into force here for easier understanding, for convenience basically. And also to understand the interaction of nuclei with each other, we will need this mass energy equivalence relation. Thank you.
Thank you. Please visit examfear.com to watch free educational videos, try free online tests, get the best quality study materials, study from the best tutors and mentors, and much more. Thank you once again.